is essentially a tool for generating patient populations. So basically, if you want to create real data for or real adjacent data for patients without it being real patient data, this lets you build those patients based on kind of useful, like expected clinical workflows. So using prevalence and demographic statistics and stuff like that to determine, you know, what should this population look like? What would we expect to see in a patient record? So with that in mind, basically Synthea sends patients through modules, and these modules, there's kind of a bunch of the top things that you know, people experience, but you know, you could definitely build additional modules to include additional clinical information. So just to kind of understand how the modules work, this is the appendicitis module. And so I think it's kind of helpful to like think about like, okay, if there's a patient that we're going through this module we're being applied to a patient as it would be applied to every patient in the set Synthea creates when you run it, what would that look like going through it? So it essentially works by stepping through a week at a time. And so there's some number of patients, you know, and then there's some max age that a patient could be. So if we said, you know, a patient could at max age be 100, Synthea would start 100 years ago and then go week by week and run patients as they start existing through the modules. So let's say that our patient was born in 1992. Then you know, it kind of step through, and then when it gets to 1992, okay, our patient is born, and we go and we execute the module here. So we start at initial, and if we go, can go to gender male, gender female, or else is the other option over here. And else just goes to the terminal state, which means basically nothing in this module is applied to that patient. But at our initial state here, just based on that patient when it's born, basic demographic information that's generated for that patient, let's say that patient is male. So we go down this transition here. So we're going from the initial state through a transition to a simple state here. So the simple state male is just saying, you know, it's simple, there's really nothing else here that's going to happen, but it's something to help kind of control our flow. So if we're in the male state, for a male, the prevalence of appendicitis is 8.6%. So at some point, 8.6% of males will get appendicitis in their lifetime. Similarly, for females, it's 6.7%. So if we look at the two transitions coming off of male here, we see 8.6% there, and the other transition, all the way down here, 91.4%. So that's the other, you know, up to 100%. They need to add up because it's two transitions going out. So otherwise, you know, they're not getting appendicitis. So again, we go to terminal, and anything else in this module doesn't execute for that patient. So if we go assume that our male gets appendicitis, so he's in that 8.6%. So we transition to this pre-appendicitis state, and this state is just representative. At some point in this person's life, they will have appendicitis. But that when that happens, it varies by age. So how common it is. So it's only 9.3% of people who get appendicitis at some point in their life get it when they're greater than 65 years old. And then so let's say that just we kind of roll the die here. And our male gets appendicitis between the ages of 1 and 17. So this state here, so once we've kind of determined we've moved to this state, this is a delay state. So the way a delay state works is you can give it a amount of time or a range of time with which the module will just stay here until that point in time is reached. So as we said, we started in 1992. Let's say our patient gets appendicitis at 16. So this is essentially a random number is chosen between 1 and 17 years later. So let's say 16 years later, so this module will delay until that age 16 has been reached. So it'll tick through week by week. You know, we're going from 1992 to 2008, and then we reach 2008, and then this state, this delay state, is like, okay, we've reached 2008, and it evaluates, and it goes through to the next state, which is appendicitis symptom one here. So the next few states are a series of symptoms. So we're sometime in, you know, 2008. Let's say, it's September 1st, 2008. So September 1st, 2008, we have the onset of symptoms. So what we can imagine kind of from here is as we go through certain things will be added to the model of this patient. So we're kind of building up the model of this patient, which we could eventually export in a couple of different formats. But we're starting to build up the model here. So in September 1st, 2008, we have the onset of a symptom, abdominal pain. So for a symptom state, so this is one of several clinical states. The symptom state has this range here. So if the symptom is somewhere in the range of certain value, then that's when you'd say, you know, yes, you're going to transition to the next state. So the symptom pain here, abdominal pain here, we assume it's somewhere in this range, randomly chosen. So we're going to assign, abdominal pain level 75 to the symptom in our model. And then similar for the next few. So the symptom fever, let's say, you know, we assign randomly 70. The symptom loss of appetite, we can say is, you know, 90. The symptom nausea vomiting is somewhere between 0 and 50, so that could be like 10. And then we have diarrhea is also 0 to 50, bloating and gas 0 to 50, and constipation 0 to 50. So we can put all of those at a random number somewhere between 0 and 50 to build up our model here. So the next thing we have here is this symptom period. So this is a delay state again, so it's similar to the delay state we saw up here with age years, but this delay state, instead of being for age, is waiting a period. So this will wait 1 to 3 days. So we briefly mentioned earlier that Synthea will take every 7 days. So when there's a delay, that's actually, you know, you might hit this off of that tick, right? So we're on September 1st. Let's say this randomly selected delay is 2 days. So 2 days selected from 1 to 3, but if we do one tick, we're going up to September 8th. So what will happen is Synthea actually does a tick forward to September 8th. And then when it realizes it's kind of past the point for this delay clause, it'll actually rewind back to September 3rd and then continue on this module. And once it does get to a state where it's kind of stuck, it'll replay that tick to September 8th. So the next thing that we're hitting here once we get to September 3rd is the appendicitis condition onset. So the condition onset is another clinical state. This is also a little bit special. So condition onset is in the model, would start on September 3rd in this case, but it actually won't set a diagnosis date until there is an encounter that is associated with it. So in this case, it won't set the diagnosis date until the appendicitis encounter. So it'll be either a concurrent or future encounter for which it will set the diagnosis. So then if we look, we can go 30% of the transitions go to a rupture versus 70% go to appendicitis encounter. So if we assume there's a rupture, there's an additional condition onset here of rupture of appendix. So both of those have diagnosed at appendicitis encounter. So once we get to the next state here, we immediately transition to appendicitis encounter. Again, this is still on September 3rd because we're not really doing any delays. There's no kind of time captures here to make this date different. So this is concurrent. So concurrently, the appendicitis counter will set the diagnosis for both the appendicitis and rupture condition onset. So at this encounter here, we have emergency room admission, reason appendicitis. So encounters are kind of a special clinical state where in Synthea, it will set the current encounter whenever you have an encounter state come up. So this appendicitis encounter will be our current encounter until we reach an encounter end. So the next state we transition to is the history of appendectomy state. So this is now a new condition onset. And again, we have a diagnosis encounter coming up. So the diagnose at appendectomy encounter will be the concurrent encounter at which this diagnosis will start. So in order for that encounter to start, first we're going to end the current encounter. So there's encounter end here, and that is for the transfer to inpatient. So that state can then move us into the next encounter, which is the appendectomy encounter. This becomes our new current encounter until the end of this encounter. And we can see this clinical state here using the SNOMED code to show that it is an encounter inpatient. And then we can set the reason to appendicitis before moving to the next state. So that gets added to our patient model, and then the appendectomy procedure gets added to our patient model. So the procedure has a duration of 40 to 70 minutes. So the duration in our patient model is going to be randomly chosen between 40 and 70 minutes. And that gets added to our model before we go to the appendicitis symptom one ends. So we're going to go through a couple of symptom ends before we end this encounter. And this procedure is kind of embedded as part of this encounter. So it will be associated with whatever the current encounter is at the time of the procedure. So we set all of the symptoms to zero that we set before to higher symptom levels. And so that will transition one to the next all the way through to recovery. And so this is the delay state. And this will actually wait here for our next tick in Synthea. So all of this was happening concurrently. There weren't delays. So all of this actually was happening on that September 3rd day. And so this recovery, we enter another delay. And if we say, 7 days from our previous tick was September 1st. So 7 days later would be September 8th. So this would be, somewhere between 1 to 5 days. If we assume that we add 3 days on here was the randomly chosen delay, then we would end up at September 6th. And that's still before our next tick. So we would stop there, do our tick, and then rewind again before going to September 8th. So recovery then on the 6th will lead us to this end appendectomy encounter. So the encounter end will be on September 6th. And we see the discharge disposition is another attribute that can be set here, showing discharge to home care, self-care. So that is kind of the end of anything to do with this appendicitis module, and we then transition to terminal. So that is all of the pieces that would be added to the model for this patient for the appendicitis module.